Kare kare has meat so tender, you can eat it all with a spoon if you wanted to. Everything's bathed with a thick peanut sauce that makes Filipinos proud to say that we have a dish that's cooked with peanut butter. It sounds like one of those kitchen hacks you hashtag because you use a different pantry ingredient, usually reserved for sandwiches and desserts. But Filipinos have been cooking this dish for many years, grinding peanuts into a paste and scraping it into a pot of simmering meat. I was surprised when a friend told me how long it took him to cook kare kare for the first time. 3 hours? What the? I was confused. My mom could get home from work at 6 o'clock and have kare kare on the table by 7:30 tops. What was her secret? Turns out there was a reason why she used those hissing pots that competed with the volume on my TV. They tenderize the meat faster and can cut 70% off your cooking time. Nowadays, we have electric pressure cookers that are quieter, leaving everyone in the house to watch Netflix undisturbed. Personally, I like to mix the bagoong or fermented shrimp paste before serving so that I already have a perfectly seasoned sauce, especially for people unfamiliar or simply turned off by the thought of it. But a lot of people, my wife included, are used to keeping the bagoong on the side of their plate, scraping just a pinch with each bite to lighten up the sauce. Happy wife, happy life.
Delicious.